Alright, I think I just made that last video with some spinach in my teeth or something, but no, it was not the spinach. I've not had a good time with my garden this year. It's been awful, actually. It's just been awful. With the too many rains that happened, the weeds grew too thick and precarious that nothing else could go through, and I planted the little tiny plants too early, and so they all failed. And no, it's been awful. And so, no, I don't have good food. I guess I'm back to stinging nettles again, as the save. Stinging nettles. So anyway, so, I don't know. It's a difficult, difficile problem, you see. Oh, je pense particulièrement à la petite ville, la petite ville Jublains, avec I don't know, en plus, le restaurant, restaurant différent. I'm thinking of a restaurant similar, you know, we have the Space Needle in Seattle. I was thinking a Romulan space vessel, to actually have a replica of a Romulan space vessel. And that would be the restaurant, and we will go into the restaurant. And it can even be a mechanical also. So part of the day, the restaurant lowers, where the people are sitting and eating, where they are eating their food. And that becomes the energy for it. So it has its own energy supply source. And then in the nighttime, they load the other side. And so that's easier for the people who are at the tables, working at the tables. Because there's this massive field there. And in that massive field, I don't know, I see a Romulan vessel could park there. That would be a wonderful idea for just the passerbys to stop, a place to just always have food. And it seems like a long way to go, just to go to a Chinese restaurant here, Xinhua, that's open. And so if we can have a place that's pretty much open more often than not, that would be better. Because this is a medium location between two large cities. And when you have, I don't know, what is it, a half hour to each, it is a stopping place. It is still a stopping place that we have to think. Well, the people will want to go away and just eat something different. And so make it a Romulan vessel, and we eat inside the Romulan vessel. And it will also be a chance to operate with the mechanism of the turbine push for energy, salvaging it off into the batteries and into that turbine battery state. From there, it can be used as a power supply for much of the local city offices, etc. Even the lights, I believe it could power the lights of the town. So we need to think along this line of rejuvenation spots, rather than dead zones. Dead zones, you know, there's a lot of dead zones and. I don't know. It's quiet. People maybe like the quiet, you know. Oh, it's so quiet. It's so quiet. After a while, you do just want to just take a knife and kill yourself. It's that quiet. Yeah, it's not great. It's not great. It's maybe a melancholic wonder as to why somebody wants to live in such a place of walking dead. It does make you wonder why. So, yeah, it's not healthy. It's not healthy. I don't believe it is a healthy state at all. I mean, to be just purely an archaeology dig, it's there. They have a spot. They've done their archaeology dig there. I don't think they want to go any further. I don't think they want to make it a Pompeian village dig, do they? I don't think they want to. They don't have the volcano. There's no volcano great. That has the people all in their predicament of shape. for the tourists to Google at. They don't have anything cool like that. They just have, well, just some old bones, maybe, you know. So no, I don't think you want to Pompeii this village. Not at all. Do not Pompeii it. No, better to make the Romulan spaceship. And then there we go. So how far back are we when we are talking entering into the future, you know, entering into the future by going into the past. We're entering into the future, we're looking at that exact exactation, that portal square exact. Something like this, you know, down there in Argentina, you know, exact, you know, nothing tilted, perfect, you know. So this has been going on before, way before we can even manage the mechanism of wonder of trade between China and the Middle East, you know. None of this was way before, you know. We're having this perfect constructionism. So where did it come from? It is saying from afar. We're always running to the Andes. We're running to the Andes and looking at those tracks, looking at those landing strips. And they were like, well, those are landing strips from a long time ago. And so who landed and how they landed. And so it is not alien necessaire, but perhaps a contingent of our particular species now. Just our inhabitant beginnings. Didn't have to actually come from Darwin straight off from the monkey. We did not have to be this evolution state. We could have landed in through the Andes. So I'm not going to state with emphatica that I am a Darwinist at all. That I have evolved thousands and thousands and thousands of years through bones to bones, and oh my gosh, I have a whisker less on my face, and so now I am a human, you know, I'm no longer a monkey. No, I'm not going to say this, I'm not going to say this at all. I'm going to actually go further and believe that we have a predicament of space human that perhaps did evolve, even go away and recovered back to Earth to start again. And in that precious moment of starting again, well, then you could say even before then there was Darwinism. Gosh dang Darwin. He does traipse the mind through. He does traipse the mind through. You know, the older I get, you know, my legs are like, what's the deal? I can't move them. I start to walk like a monkey or something. I can't get them straight enough, you know. I have to really go back to ballet. It's the only way to get my legs straight. You know, it's like, what's the deal? It's like a force. And so with Darwinism, oh, it is a plague on me. Because I want to be actually a Darwin species, nutritive out of. You know, I actually do want to. I want to say yes emphatically. I am one of those. But yet I have also this group in the Andes that have landed. They have landed many years ago, and they've created these portals that are absolutely tremendous in shape. And exact. And when this is going on, we have to question, you know, were they here before, and they Darwined out, you know, if they were here before, and they were the Darwin species that materialized, and then they got themselves out on the ship, and then they turned around, and then they came back. You know what I'm saying? And then we started from that group in the Andes. You know what I'm saying? If we started from that group, that's something we need to contemplate. Yeah, I really like the Romulan idea though, the parking a spaceship out there. It's just, gosh dang, what a dead zone. This is a dead zone of a town. really, really, I don't know. I don't know, rules, I can make more rules for France, I guess it's good for that. You can call it, what, you want a Camp David here, and call it the Camp France of making rules for the kingdom. But I get tired of the rules, I want to talk about other things here. And yeah, that would be a good idea. We make the spaceship, a Romulan, and you can go exact. I mean, they have experts that know exactly what the Romulan looks like, the Romulan spaceships. And so park one of those and there it is. Half day eating, seating in one half of the restaurant, and it lowers and it pushes that turbine. And then in the nighttime they load in on the other side, and then they push that turbine down again, just by the weight of themselves being there, or the pressure on it, just the pressure. And so that loads and powers the energy, and that energy is a direct outlay to the city streets. This particular type can be used also in places where it rains often. You don't want to use other methodologies. Yeah. Well, anyway, yeah, I like other ways. We don't have to just have, you know, the downhill racer version, you know, on the little wheels. There are many other ways to. So, yeah, and that also gives work. It gives interesting work for the people, and it's not a milk shop, because I think there is a milk shop here, down the road in Mayen, and I don't believe that is something that enheartens the people into any greatness of self. I think they need other types of occupations. Way too much is particular. This is the milk and the cheese or whatever. This is agriculture only, you know. It's just like, oh, I don't know. Give them something else, or at least try to specialize that agriculture to make it more specific and more a luxuriant time in their life, rather than just, when I say luxuriant, I mean just from information, you know, new information. Rather than the same drudge chore, that's the field I go and I mow, that's the field I go and I mow, and that's the field I go and I mow, and I'm just brain dead because that's the field I go and I mow. And that's what they do, you know what I'm saying? And so we have to make it that's the field you go and mow, but now you have three plants different. And now you have even 17. And so there we go, and then we have new brain activity, and we're not just charged by being droldoms like the wind that goes by that we hate. Then it becomes something like, oh my goodness, an expansionism state of the brain. So yeah, we have to think about the local people in these agricultural areas, that they are kept with some kind of decency and respect to their brain growth, because they are creating new generations. When each generation, they're creating maybe stupids and more stupids and further stupids. And that is not the goal of agriculture. That is not the goal of the human race, is to continue with more and more stupids. We want to upgrade. We want to upgrade out of it. So, all right. Great. Anyway, do I need to make that all in French? I don't know. Yeah, Romulan spaceship. Et pas. Yeah, what do you call that? It's a field. Sometimes they call a field a cour. Le cours de la ville. So yeah, sometimes they call it a heart. That type of a place. All right. Yeah, spaceship. That'll, you know, hey.